Kucho.
President, please visit it. The chamber is back in session and the floor is given to the co-prosecutor to put more questions to the witness. You may now proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. So you said just before the break that Miasmut was the head of Division 164 and that Dum was his deputy until he was arrested. Were there other committee members in Division 164, and who were these members?
Mihmut was first, and the second one was Dum.
Il y avait d'abord Mihmut, et le numéro 2 c'était Dum.
And the third one was Chang.
Le troisième c'était Chan.
But I could not recall their surnames.
Mais je ne me souviens pas.
And the fourth one was Nyan.
Et le quatrième c'était Nyan.
Est-ce que toutes les décisions et les
ordres were all decisions and orders concerning operations
des régiments, la division
164, of the regiments of Division 164, as well as the assignments, were all these taken in a centralized way by these four committee members at HQ?
The four persons had the authority to issue order.
Les quatre personnes avaient l'autorité nécessaire based on pour
the
donner des ordres.
Particular needs and their order
des besoins
went to Regiment 140.
Les ordres étaient transmis au régiment 140.
And the orders also came from the division level
to
unit
62,
63, and 64. So the order came from the four persons I mentioned earlier.
Les ordres venaient des quatre personnes que j'ai mentionnées plus tôt.
Donc, au niveau de la chaîne
so,
de commandement,
in terms of the chain of command, you just spoke about the division,
qui donnait des ordres
which
aux différents
would issue orders to the different regiments.
Est-ce que les ordres et les instructions étaient ensuite
were the orders and instructions then
plus bas par
sent
les régiments,
to a lower level by the regiments and to which level
et comment est-ce que vous
and how would you receive the orders and
division.
Instructions from the division?
Regarding the chain of commands, the division issue order to the regiment and the regiment issue order down to the brigade and brigade down to rather the regiment down to the battalion and battalion down to the company.
And now regarding the reports that had to be drafted, did these reports follow the same pathway but in the opposite direction, that is to say from bottom to top? That is to say, would you report to your battalion chief who would report to the regiment chief who would then report to the division chief? Was that the way things happened?
Yes, that was the way things happened. We needed to report according to the level, each level of higher authority.
Nous devions faire
that was the common practice at that time.
C'était la pratique à l'époque.
Dans cette structure
in
hiérarchisée,
this hierarchical structure,
hiérarchisée, cette structure militaire,
which was very, in fact, strictly hierarchized, did the lower-ranking cadres
de votre niveau,
that is, say, cadres of your level,
le droit de ne pas obéir
have
aux ordres,
the right not to obey orders?
Les ordres de la hiérarchie,
did they have the right to
soit.
Ignore orders coming from the higher levels?
At at that time, in my capacity as the commander of the company,
en tant que commandant de compagnie,
whatever the order came from the upper level,
que soient les we ordres could not qui venaient de l'échelon supérieur, avoid it. D'en haut, nous ne pouvions pas
we
nous
had
dérober.
To carry it. And this was
nous devions exécuter
what I said from my capacity as the commander of the
vessel.
So
navire.
We had to implement according to the order. For example, as to how many days the training need to take place and how many days the trainee could take rest. So everything was based on the order.
La personne qui était formée, le nombre de jours de repos, tout dépendait des ordres.
Concernant les
now,
opérations
regarding
de terrain,
field operations,
y avait-il des exceptions où vous pouviez
were
ne
there
pas
any exceptional instances
les ordres, ou bien
when you
en toutes circonstances
were allowed not to obey orders, or did you have to obey orders at all times?
การวัดแผนการเตาทัวตามตัวตามเมียนไปเรื่อย
Concerning the operation, we had to implement according to the order.
Nous devions mettre en œuvre en fonction des ordres.
If we did not obey the order,
si
it took place only in special circumstances, for example, when the individual was sick or very busy. So everyone who received the order needed to obey the order. They could not avoid it.
Obéir à cet ordre, ne pouvait pas s'y dérober.
Et en cas de désobéissance aux ordres,
when people disobeyed,
qu'arrivait-il?
What would happen?
À ceux qui désobéissent.
To those who disobeyed the orders.
Dans le cas où il y a
in case there were individuals who disobeyed the order.
S'il y avait des individus qui désobéissaient aux ordres.
They needed to do the tasks that assigned to them, and those tasks were supposed
faire la tâche qui leur
that
était confiée,
they could carry out.
Dont on pensait qu'elle pouvait être menée.
I'm not sure that I got your full answer. Well, to be more specific, in case of severe disobedience, for example, a Navy chief who would refuse to stop a Vietnamese boat coming into Cambodian territorial waters,
what would,
in this case, would this chief be sanctioned, punished?
President, Mr. Witness, please hold on. The floor is given to Council Kung Samon. Kung Samon, Mr. President, I would like to object this question because this question leads the witness to speculate. Thank you.
Pas du tout, monsieur le
Président. Not at all, Mr. President. I'm simply referring to examples that he might have encountered of chiefs who might have disobeyed
voilà,
the order. So
témoin,
I simply wanted witness
quelles étaient les sanctions
to have you tell me
selon
what
vous saviez à l'époque,
were the
en cas de désobéissance
sanctions
grave
if people disobeyed orders in Division 164.
President.
President.
Do you have any facts to established and to show to the witness that there was the case of this obedience by the military commanders, and if no specific facts put to the witness, it is a kind of question to draw a speculation from the witness. So if you have the orders to show the witness, and then it is appropriate. You can ask if there were orders. So how did those people respect and disrespect the orders?
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Je crois que je vais procéder.
Thank you, Mr. President. I think I'm going to proceed otherwise. I'm going to read out what the witness said in his WRI E319/23.3.54.
Question 116.
Question 116.
On vous a posé la question suivante.
The following question was put to you.
Vous avez assisté à une réunion.
You attended a meeting
durant laquelle vous avez reçu des instructions
you received orders aiming to implement the great policies,
dont le nettoyage des ennemis,
including the cleansing of enemies and of the Vietnamese.
Qu'est-il arrivé aux cadres?
What happened to the cadres who refused to obey these orders?
Vous avez répondu
and you answered the following.
À la réponse 116.
At answer 116.
Vers la fin de cette réponse,
towards the end of that answer, if we did not obey,
Ankar, à la formation,
they would send us to training,
ou à la
or they would send us to be re-educated.
Question 119.
Question 119.
Normalement,
normally,
ceux qui étaient envoyés
those
à la
who were sent to be re-educated by their unit, did they come back
après?
To their unit afterwards?
Réponse
answer,
que vous avez donné,
the answer that you provided.
Personne n'est revenu.
Nobody
ils
came
ont
back.
Disparu pour toujours.
They all disappeared forever. End of quote. Free translation.
La seule exception que vous avez
the
mentionné,
only
je
exception
crois,
you mentioned
Chun,
is the example of Chun,
chantier de construction
who went
de l'aéroport
to the Kompong Shnang work site, airport work site.
J'aimerais savoir
so
que vous
I would
avez
like to know
vous entendez par
what you mean
ré-éducation.
By re-education, because
on a
earlier,
parlé de
when we spoke about
S21,
you said that it was a re-education center.
Est-ce que
so,
quand les gens étaient envoyés
when people were sent to be re-educated, did that mean that they were sent to a security center, or did that mean
chose?
Something else?
Answer,
based on the practices which I made mention in my documents, I was referring to the offenders, those who committed offenses, particularly those who committed wrongs,
ceux qui avaient mal agi, commis une faute.
Sending them to a far location or close location did not happen within my company, but it did happen in others' companies. I am now speaking in the circumstances that some companies sent those people to the places you, the locations you mentioned, and those who had been sent never returned. This is the statement in my document.
Voilà ce que j'ai dit dans mes documents.
So I am talking only what happened
donc je ne parle que de ce qu'il
outside
passé
of my company.
À l'extérieur de ma compagnie.
And you can refer to my example earlier.
Et vous pouvez vous référer à mon exemple un peu plus tôt.
I was in charge of the vessels.
J'étais responsable des navires.
I never encountered such events you described, but it happened. It did happen in other companies.
Mais c'est arrivé dans d'autres compagnies ou dans d'autres unités.
Donc, si je vous comprends bien, vous avez
so if I understood you well,
scrupuleusement respecté
you
les ordres
respected
qui vous
the orders that were sent to you by your hierarchy scrupulously. So there were no instances of disobedience in your case.
Answer, that is the case.
Oui,
it is true.
C'est exact.
I was a practical person.
J'étais une personne pratique.
So what I did, what I was doing at the time,
donc ce que je faisais à ce moment-là,
reflected who I was.
Reflétait qui j'étais.
I never implemented any orders or regulations contrasting with the line.
De règlement ou de règles qui allaient à l'encontre de la ligne.
D'accord. Et à l'inverse, est-ce que les cadres subalternes comme vous,
on the contrary,
au niveau des compagnies, au niveau
des lower-ranking cadres such as you,
capitaine de bateau,
within the companies or on the vessels,
est-ce qu'ils avaient le droit de prendre
were they allowed
initiatives
to take initiatives on their own
or
to take important decisions
à bord de leur
on
bateau
board their vessels
sans consulter
without
la hiérarchie,
speaking to their superiors,
si
without knowing if their superiors would agree to that?
Answer, concerning the implementation of tactical strategies.
À propos de la mise en œuvre de stratégies tactiques,
when
exemple,
a machine did not work and we need to repair, we needed to repair it.
Et qu'il nous fallait la réparer.
This kind of issue needed to make a request to regiment.
Et il fallait pour ce type de
to battalion, regiment,
faire
and division, and after which there would be a reply, a response from those levels.
De la part
after that
de
time,
niveaux.
We were able to repair the machine.
Que nous pouvions réparer la machine.
Merci.
Thank you. Now I would like
thème.
To turn to another topic.
Nous développerons davantage. Qui s'est passé autour des îles
we will speak
demain.
More about what happened around the islands tomorrow. Today I already spoke about this topic for a part, but before I go into depth about this, I'd like to speak about the ceremonies or the meetings that you might have attended in Phnom Penh during the DK regime.
Est-ce que
and
vous vous êtes rendu,
did you,
à part la réunion qui a déjà été évoquée, avec Son Sen,
travel
est-ce que vous êtes rendu à d'autres occasions
to Phnom Penh on other occasions aside from the meeting you spoke about with Son Sen,
de réunion,
in
meeting,
particular during
des cadres du parti
major
de
meetings of party cadres and army cadres at the Olympic Stadium
ou à d'autres endroits,
or in other places
à l'occasion de célébrations,
for celebrations
de Phnom Penh,
such as the celebration of the capture of Phnom Penh on 17 April,
celle de l'anniversaire de la fondation
or maybe the anniversary of the foundation of the party on 30 September, or the anniversary of the creation of the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea, which was celebrated, I believe, in January. Did you go to Phnom Penh to attend these kinds of ceremonies or to take part in these major meetings?
Answer. Concerning the attendance within the anniversary of the parties of the party and of the victory on the 17 April,
la victoire du 17 avril,
my company did not come to Phnom Penh to attend the ceremony. We would hold the ceremony within Kampong Sam location. However, when cadres were invited by the commander-in-chief, for instance, the commissioners of divisions, regiments, battalions were invited, they would come
invités
to attend the study sessions, said the witness.
aux séances d'études.
Well, it appears to me that in your DCCAM interview, you said on page 91
en anglais,
in English,
et à la page en
and on Khmer page 00926419, that you stayed in Phnom Penh in 1976-1977,
vous avez vu Paul Pot
and that you saw Pol Pot
faire un discours à l'époque,
give a speech
et qu'il avait fait
and
le, un 17
that
avril.
He gave that speech on the 17th of April.
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez
so
de l'avoir dit
do you remember having said that?
Answer. In that document, I attended one meeting when I saw Pol Pot deliver the speech in Phnom Penh. That meeting was held in Olympic Stadium.
Au stade olympique.
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez de l'année?
Do you remember the year
when this meeting was held?
For which you traveled to Phnom Penh?
Answer. It may have happened in 1977.
C'était peut-être en 1977.
Est-ce que durant le régime
during
the
DDK regime, did you have the opportunity to listen to Radio Phnom Penh or to read issues of Revolutionary Flag or Revolutionary Youth? I think you spoke about this in your interview, in fact.
Answer. I received the Revolutionary Flags or Red Flags or magazines on a monthly basis, and I could have the access to the radio broadcast daily.
Radio au quotidien.
J'en conclue donc
so
que
therefore,
vous étiez
I
du
must
parti,
conclude that you were a party member. Is that correct?
Answer, yes, that is correct.
Oui, c'est exact.
Je voudrais lire
now, I would like to read out excerpts of a speech given by Pol Pot,
qui est paru justement dans un étendard
which in fact appeared in an issue of Revolutionary Flag, and I'd like to see if you're familiar with the issues he brought up or with the words he used in this speech, which was given on 17 April 1978.
It's document E3/4604. C'est donc un
and it's therefore an excerpt of the speech of Comrade Secretary of the CPK, and a first excerpt is on French page 0052-0344, English
005-1-9-833-3-4
and
3-4,
and Khmer,
c'est mais je crois
it's
que
quite
0,
approximate,
0,
but I believe it's 00-064-713-714. And Pol Pot,
in
this speech, speaks about the Vietnamese enemy, and this is what he says.
Le parti
the party
a demandé
requested
à ce qu'on
that
les
we crush
des ennemis
the enemy forces
le plus possible.
As much as possible.
Et a demandé à
and
ce qu'on défende
that we defend our own forces
le plus
as much as possible.
Nous sommes peu nombreux.
There are not many
nous
of us,
nous attaquer
but
aux
we have to attack the enemies
nombreux.
Who are more numerous than we are.
Donc,
so,
nous devons
therefore,
protéger
we must
nos
protect
forces
our forces to the best
et écraser leurs forces
crush their
le
forces
possible.
As much as possible.
Voici notre
this is
slogan
our slogan,
qui repose entièrement
which
sur des chiffres.
Entirely relies on figures.
Un de nos
one of our men must manage to defeat 30 Vietnamese at all costs.
Si nous
if we manage to follow
ce slogan,
this slogan,
nous
we will win.
Peu importe
no matter
le nombre
the number of
Vietnamese
people,
nous remporterions la
we
victoire sur eux
will triumph
en fin de compte.
Over them in the end.
Par rapport à n'importe
in relation to any other country
Cambodge,
that would invade
si
Cambodia, if we put
slogan,
into practice what is said in the slogan, we will win for sure.
Jusqu'à ce jour, nous sommes parvenus Up until today, à appliquer le slogan
we managed to implement
de 1 contre 30.
What is said fin in the slogan, citation. That is to say, the principle of 1 against 30. End
Dans
of quote, free translation. In this excerpt,
vous avez peut-être entendu
you maybe
que Pol Pot parle
heard that Pol Pot was speaking about
du fait que peu
the fact that no matter
the
number of Vietnamese people,
il ne fait donc pas de distinction entre militaires.
He, therefore, he's not making any distinction between Vietnamese civilians and Vietnamese
Est-ce
soldiers.
Que vous l'avez entendu dire
so did you hear him say that the enemies,
Vietnam,
or the enemy, which was Vietnam,
les habitants vietnamiens.
Also included Vietnamese civilians?
President, please hold on, Mr. Winner, you have the floor now, Copa.
Thank you, Mr. President. I object to this question. The revolutionary flag clearly indicates that the speech was about Vietnamese troops. It's only troops. Troops that he speaks about.
It's the exact same thing that he did in an interview in December 78 with Elizabeth Becker.
It's very clear in that interview when he speaks about
Vietnamese troops or Vietnamese military or Vietnam in general
as a country in its policy. He talks about Yun. When he talks about Vietnamese people, he talks about people from Vietnam.
He makes that
distinction very explicitly.
But here, it's
very clear. He speaks about war with
on
Vietnam
voit très clairement
and the crushing
qu'il parle de la guerre
troops,
avec
not
Vietnam.
About civilians.
Il évoque les troupes vietnamiennes et ne parle pas des civils.
Monsieur le Président, j'ai lu un extrait
Mr.
C'est
President,
assez clair qui parle des
I have read out an extract and it is very clear it talks of Vietnamese inhabitants. Regardless of the vision of the defense as regards this speech, I am relying on an extract of this speech. There are other extracts that I will read out and they also refer to Vietnamese inhabitants and not to Vietnamese soldiers. So may I request your leave to put this question to the witness.
President, the objection put by Victor Copé is overruled. There is a clear basis on the question put by the international deputy co-prosecutor. Mr. Winners, you are instructed to respond to the question put by the international co-prosecutor. And if you do not recall it, you can ask the co-prosecutor to repeat it.
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez avoir entendu dire
Do you remember having heard Pol Pot say that
l'ennemi de Vietnam
the enemy
les ennemis vietnamiens c'était les habitants vietnamiens
the Vietnamese enemy were the Vietnamese inhabitants
tam ឯកសារទង
answer
ជានឹងគឺវាជាគោលនយោបាយសំខាន់
In accordance with the revolutionary flag,
there
was a clear policy and strict guidelines for cadres to understand. But I would like to make a clear point that one of our soldiers needed to smash 30 Vietnamese soldiers who committed the aggression against the country. This was the guidelines made mention by Comrade Pol Pot in the revolutionary flag. That was true. That was the true statement made by him. The enemies of the Democratic Cambodia during that time had a very big ambition.
De grandes ambitions.
I did have the same understanding of Comrade Secretary.
J'ai compris la même chose que le camarade Jamba
was swallowed by Yuen. Cambodia Crown, or lower part of Cambodia, was swallowed by Yuen. So there was a plan to swallow the country of Cambodia as well. As of now, this is still the case. I am one of Cambodian citizens and I am still I am still having the idea and understanding that there is still an ambition to swallow this country.
Cette ambition consistant à engloutir, à avaler, phagocyter.
President, Mr. Winness, please try your utmost to answer the question put to you, and you may only respond to the question to the limit of it. Please avoid stating your personal opinions, which are not contributing to the assessment of the truth. It is your objective or subjective perception, but please give your response within the sphere of the answer, the question.
Merci. Au moins, comme ça, on sait.
Thank you, at least you
dans ce
know.
Discours, vous dites le slogan 1 contre 1, 1 contre 30, c'était adressé
in this speech,
aux
it is said
soldats
that
vietnamiens.
It was one
en réalité,
Khmer soldier against
on parle effectivement des forces, Pol Pot,
Vietnamese.
Qui se réfère également au chiffre de 2 millions
the forces
de Cambodgiens qui suffiraient à éliminer
and
60 millions de Vietnamiens.
It is said that 2 million Cambodians would be enough to fight 60 million Vietnamese.
He keeps misleading you, Mr. President. He's talking about 30
non,
Vietnamese
il parle
troops,
de 30 soldats vietnamiens. 1 to 30, ce sont les soldats,
that was the amount of soldiers that
the nombre de soldats
army had more. There's no mention at all
vietnamienne. Il n'y a
Vietnamese
aucune
civilians.
Mention
so
de
really
civils vietnamiens.
You.
Et là, c'est induire la chambre en erreur.
Et peut-être une observation, si on peut
like
dire, Monsieur le Président,
remark,
parce que dans le document qu'a cité mon confrère, que je lis également en français,
cited,
il y a effectivement une traduction
French,
du mot Yun qui est faite en français,
Yun,
qui est faite comme étant habitant vietnamien, mais dans la version anglaise et dans la version
inhabitant.
Khmer,
whereas
c'est le mot Yun qui
English
apparaît.
The word
je,
is
nous
yun.
Avons le même problème en,
so
en français, mais en tout cas en anglais.
In
et en khmer, c'est le mot yun et non pas la, le vocable
khmer,
habitant
the word
vietnamien.
Use is yun, and there is no mention of the word Vietnamese.
President, you have the floor now.
Kong
Samon. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
I want to have an observation
j'ai
on the document,
sur ce document
quoted. The Khmer is the original version.
L'original est en Khmer.
And in Khmer document, it states
en Khmer, il est
the document makes mention about Vietnamese troops and soldiers,
on parle de
not civilians.
On ne parle pas de civil.
So during some sentences below the line, which is clear about soldiers or forces may use the pronoun to replace the words instead. So we have to be clear on the number
cette ligne
of forces.
Suivre les lignes précédentes qui parlaient de soldats
Vietnamese
et donc il s'agit peut-être d'un pronom qui fait référence et pourquoi on parle ici de 30 soldats vietnamiens.
Monsieur le Président,
Mr. President,
je peux poursuivre. Je n'ai pas la référence exacte, mais je sais que dans ce discours.
Exact
reference, je retrouverai la référence, je la communiquerai
but I know
demain.
That if I were to
il
look at that speech, I'll
après,
see the exact reference, I'll find it tomorrow. And it is said shortly thereafter that with 2 million Cambodians, you would be able to defeat 60 million Vietnamese. And
est-ce que, Monsieur
6
Pumain,
million
vous avez
would stay below. Mr. Witness, did you hear Pol Pot say that?
Answer, this was a comparison of forces, of military forces, 1 to 30.
1 versus 30, 1 pour 30.
It is clear in the document.
C'est clair dans le document.
And this is the document which quote the statement of Comrade Secretary, it was meant to encourage the soldiers to use the strategies to smash
discours encourageant les soldats à faire preuve de stratégie, utiliser des tactiques pour les écraser.
Est-ce que je comprends que vous voulez dire que
l'ensemble
des habitants du Vietnam étaient des soldats, 60 millions?
The Vietnamese inhabitants were soldiers,
dans le discours,
that is the 60 million,
fait référence aux 100 000
because
forces
in the speech, reference is made to 100,000 Cambodian troops against a million
Donc, est-ce qu'il y
Vietnamese.
Avait 60 millions de soldats au Vietnam, monsieur le témoin?
There were 60 million soldiers in Vietnam, sir.
Answer. In fact, Vietnamese soldiers did not consist of 60 million, and Cambodian or Cambodian soldiers consisted of 2 million. The statement was meant to inspire Cambodian soldiers to utilize and prepare the lines to attack and capture the victory.
Et saisir la victoire.
Très bien, je reste là pour cet extrait-là.
Very well.
Un autre extrait.
I'll leave it there for that extract. There's another
en français,
extract.
005,
further down, it's in French, 005-203-8.
En anglais, 005-1-9-8-3-6. Et en Khmer,
000-64-7-1-7.
Il est dit, Pol Pot dit ceci.
And Pol Pot says the following.
Je cite.
And I quote.
Depuis toujours, est-ce que les Vietnamiens nous ont vaincus?
Since the very beginning, have the Vietnamese?
Ils ont toujours eu envie de s'emparer du Cambodge.
They have always
pour en
wanted
faire leur
to take
vassal depuis 1930.
Cambodia to make it its vassal since 1930.
En 1970, est-ce qu'ils ont été capables de s'en emparer?
In 1970, could they take Cambodia?
They could not take it. En 1975, ont-ils pu prendre le Cambodge
en main? Were they able to take Cambodia?
Ils ont échoué.
They could not.
Jusqu'à nos jours,
and
où
now,
en sont-ils?
How about the Yuan?
Ils ne sont plus présents sur le territoire du Cambodge.
They are no longer present.
Auparavant, presque 1 million de Vietnamiens étaient là.
Nearly 1 million of them.
Maintenant, on n'en trouve même plus.
Now, there is not one seed.
Et en anglais, je crois qu'on parle de
and
seed.
In English, I believe reference is made to seed.
Je continue.
And
par conséquent, sur le plan idéologique, nous n'avons pas failli.
The ideological standpoint, we have not failed. End of quote. Part of it was free translation.
Est-ce que, monsieur le témoin, vous avez entendu Pol Pot ou d'autres dirigeants
Pol Pot
du parti
or other party
ou de
leaders,
la division 164
or officials of division 164
évoquer le fait que des mesures avaient été prises contre
had been
les
taken
Vietnamiens qui résidaient
against
au Cambodge
the Vietnamese residing in Cambodia
avant la prise de Phnom Penh le 17 avril
the capture
1975.
Of Phnom Penh on the 17th of April 1975. Answer. From the statements you raised, and it is my understanding that that was the political line and also ideological standpoint, and it was meant to raise the spirits of soldiers to be ready in the battlefield, which was possible between Cambodian soldiers and Vietnamese soldiers. That was the real statement he made at the time, and it was like you know, a roadmap.
La déclaration concrète qu'il a faite, et c'était en fait une feuille de route.
D'accord, mais toujours est-il que
well.
Il a parlé d'un million de Vietnamiens qui habitaient au Cambodge avant
in Cambodia.
Il arrive.
Before
qu'il
he came
plus.
To power, alors, that there weren't any left.
Vous avez entendu parler.
Now, did you
de mesures prises contre les Vietnamiens, notamment la déportation des Vietnamiens vers le Vietnam par les dirigeants du Cambodge démocratique au début du régime.
At the beginning of the regime.
Le président.
President, Mr. Witness, please hold on, and the floor is given to Counsel Victor Kopé.
I object to the form of this question,
Je m'oppose à la façon dont la question est posée.
Prosecution is leaving only one option.
Le procureur ne laisse qu'une option possible pour témoin de dire pourquoi il y avait si peu de Vietnamiens après 75.
One of the experts. More experts actually
un des experts, enfin plusieurs experts même, ont parlé de déportations en masse de Vietnamiens par le Nol avant 75.
I think it's fair if that is also included in the question.
Donc, je pense qu'il serait juste d'inclure cela aussi dans la question posée au témoin.
Monsieur le Président, j'en suis à parler
Mr. President,
du régime du Kampuchea démocratique.
I am talking of the democratic Kampuchea regime and not about what happened before. We know that indeed the Lon Nol regime took measures against the Vietnamese, but that is not the thrust of my question.
Concernant des mesures prises
I am putting questions to the witness regarding measures taken by the government,
du Kampuchea démocratique vis-à-vis
the government of democratic Kampuchea. Vis-à-vis des Vietnamese.
Objection by Counsel Victor Kopé is overruled. The question is appropriate, so Mr. Witness, please answer to the question put to you by the co-prosecutor. Witness. I could not recall the year.
Je ne me souviens pas de l'année.
Regarding the deportation of the Vietnamese to Vietnam,
la déportation
I could not remember
Vietnam,
when it happened.
Je ne me souviens pas quand cela s'est produit.
But I knew that there was deportation of the Vietnamese.
Je savais toutefois qu'il y avait eu des déportations.
Once in 1973.
Une fois en 73.
And there was also fighting in that year.
Et cette année-là, il y a aussi eu des combats.
And another deportation took place in 1975
Ensuite,
or 1976. I could not remember well whether it was 1975 or 76, but there was another deportation at that time.
Une autre déportation à ce moment-là.
Est-ce que les Vietnamiens qui n'avaient pas été déportés en 75 et 76
Vietnamese who were not deported in 1975 and 1976
de mesures répressives par la suite en 77 et 78 dans le pays
subsequently in 1977 and 1978 in the country
qui habitaient au Cambodge
we're talking of people who lived in Cambodia but who were no longer living in Cambodia subsequently.
I cannot answer that question because it was beyond my scope of responsibility.
Mr. President.
Mr. Witness.
Monsieur le témoin.
You cannot answer that. You chose not to answer the question.
Vous ne pouvez pas choisir
because
répondre,
according to the instruction I read earlier that you had the responsibility to give answer to every question. You could say yes or no to the question,
oui ou non.
But you could not choose not to answer the question like this. Witness, my apology. Now, I would like to rephrase my answer.
Je vais donc reformuler ma réponse.
I would like to say that I did not know about that matter because
rien à ce sujet.
I was based at a different location.
Moi, j'étais basé à un autre endroit.
So that's my answer to your question.
Voilà ma réponse à votre question.
Alors, dernier extrait du discours de Phnom Penh,
Paul Pot
se trouve à la page 005-2-03-5-1 en français.
5-1 en français. 005-2-03-5-1.
En anglais, 005-1-9-8-3. Non, pardon, 9-3-8.
Or rather, 9-3-8. Up to
Khmer 00064 72 0. Je cite cet extrait du discours.
This extract of that speech.
Les Vietnamiens veulent encore tromper les gens. Ils disent qu'ils reconnaissent la frontière terrestre, la frontière des îles, mais ils ne reconnaissent pas la frontière maritime. Ils demandent à négocier encore avec nous sur la question de la frontière maritime. Cependant, le parti a décidé qu'il faut continuer à faire la guerre avec eux. Il faut faire la guerre jusqu'à ce qu'ils reconnaissent et la frontière maritime et la frontière aérienne. Il faut continuer à se battre à 1 contre 30 pour qu'ils reconnaissent. Il faut qu'ils le reconnaissent sur le papier et sur la scène internationale et jusqu'à ce qu'ils n'osent plus s'approcher de notre frontière.
On the world scene and il faut dare encore not approach leur faire our borders la guerre.
We must nous, notre keep on devoir de défense de notre frontière,
in our mission,
c'est tout simplement la guerre.
We have to keep on defending. We must fight.
Fin de citation.
End of quote. Part of it was free
concernant
translation.
Les frontières maritimes regarding à l'époque maritime où vous serviez boundaries at the time, dans la division 164,
when you were
dans le régiment
serving
140.
In division 164, in regiment 140.
Est-ce correct, d'après ce discours de Pol Pot, according de dire que les frontières qui étaient reconnues
Pol Pot, is it the
par les Cambodgiens n'étaient pas les mêmes que celles reconnues par les Vietnamiens?
The
Je parle des eaux territoriales.
I am
la distance
of
des eaux territoriales
waters,
par rapport aux îles faisait-elle l'objet
of territorial waters
d'un
from
débat
the islands,
entre Vietnamiens
which was the subject
et Cambodgiens.
The debate between the Vietnamese and the Cambodians. Which were in dispute between the Vietnamese and the Cambodians.
In fact, I was not aware of that matter.
Je n'étais pas au courant de cela.
Because it was under the authority of the upper echelon.
Cela,
specifically the Democratic,
du ressort de
the Democratic Cambodian government,
surtout le gouvernement,
that was in charge of that matter in relation to Vietnam.
En relation avec le Vietnam.
Est-il arrivé que des marins vietnamiens arrêtés sur des bateaux
Vietnamese
à proximité des îles cambodgiennes
contestent
le fait qu'ils étaient dans les eaux territoriales cambodgiennes?
Let me clarify. Based on the information I received through the radio communication,
that
Vietnamese
par communication
troops
radio,
or Vietnamese boats
les
which
entered
Cambodian territorial water,
that
I already gave my answer to question earlier,
j'ai déjà répondu, d'ailleurs, une question plus tôt.
One day there was one Vietnam and one Klang ethnicity
jour, il y avait un,
on the island.
Sur l'île, un
and
Vietnam
I asked
un ethnie Klang
a soldier there
sur l'île, et j'ai demandé aux soldats
about where they came from.
D'où
and
venait.
The soldier told me he came from the southeast
le m'a dit qu'il venait du
island.
De l'île du sud-est.
And I asked, how far was it from Tang Island and how far was it from the Vietnamese maritime boundary?
Et de la limite maritime vietnamienne.
So the people, the soldiers who went out to arrest those people,
qui sont allés arrêter ces gens,
we were not sure whether they arrested it from within Cambodian maritime boundary or inside the Vietnam maritime boundary.
Territoriale cambodgienne ou vietnamienne.
Donc vous n'étiez pas certain que cette arrestation avait
so
eu lieu
not sure that
dans les eaux territoriales cambodgiennes. Est-ce que vous avez entendu d'autres
waters?
Exemples de ce type?
Do you have other similar
que des bateaux auraient été arraisonnés alors
boats
qui n'étaient pas
were
clairs
arrested, whereas
dans quelles eaux territoriales ils se trouvaient?
In which territorial waters those boats were arrested or seized?
Based on the information I received,
d'après les renseignements que j'ai reçus,
and this information was received through radio communication between
radio,
the regiment level,
entre le niveau le régiment.
And the decision came from the regiment to my
et
vessel.
Donc, la décision est venue du régiment
I
et a été communiquée à mon
to be careful
que
because
je
based on the
attention,
information
preuve
sent
de prudence,
to the regiment,
car d'après les informations qui avaient été envoyées au régiment, il y avait des navires qui entraient dans
maritime
nos eaux
water.
Territoriales. Donc, nous devons faire
it,
preuve de vigilance.
It approached our islands in the southeast location.
Et donc que des navires approchaient par le sud-ouest ou
so
le sud-est plutôt.
The information was communicated every day.
Ces informations
to the
étaient
vessels
communiquées aux navires
and
tous les jours.
Reminding the people in charge
appeler
of each vessel to be on alert about this.
De faire preuve de vigilance.
Juste pour clarifier, vous avez en français, on entend chaque fois
matters,
une personne de l'ethnie
we,
Klang. Je ne suis pas sûr d'avoir bien entendu.
We heard something, someone of the Klang ethnic group.
Votre interview, c'est des Kam. Est-ce que c'était une personne de nationalité ou d'apparence indienne?
Cam, are we talking of someone of Indian nationality or Indian appearance?
I am not sure about
je
this.
Je n'en suis pas certain.
But I would like to clarify that I asked the soldier who stood next to the two persons.
J'ai demandé au soldat qui était à côté des deux personnes.
One was a Vietnamese and another one was of Klang ethnicity.
Et l'autre était Klang.
And then I walked past to do my task.
Et ensuite, je suis allé faire ma
so
tâche.
So I'm not sure whether the person of Klang ethnicity
si cette
was
Klang
in fact of Indian
en fait Indien
ethnicity or not.
Je ne sais pas.
Merci. Je vais vous demander d'être plus court dans vos
thank
réponses
you.
Si c'est possible.
May I request you to be more brief in answering my
au
questions because we're running out of time.
Pol Pot faire un discours un 17 avril.
When
vous
you
avez
heard
pensé
Pol Pot deliver his message on the 17th of April,
est-ce que vous avez également vu
you said you thought it was 1977. Did you also see Khieu Samphan on that occasion?
Khieu Samphan did not attend it.
Khieu Samphan n'était pas là.
Est-ce que vous avez vu Khieu Samphan prononcer un discours
did
à une
you?
Autre occasion alors?
See Khieu Samphan deliver another speech on another occasion.
Based on my recollection,
d'après mes souvenirs,
Khieu Samphan delivered speech
Khieu
through
Samphan
the radio.
Donnait des discours par la radio.
Every year.
Chaque année.
I never listened to his speech personally.
Mais je n'ai jamais, je ne l'ai jamais
at any
vu
location, I only heard
discours
his speech through
j'ai
the radio.
J'ai simplement entendu ses discours à la radio.
En tout cas, devant le CDCAM, vous
in
avez
case,
dit que vous l'aviez vu.
DCCAM, you did say that.
Faire un discours.
You saw him delivering
a speech.
Vous aviez
parlé à ce moment-là également du discours de Pol Pot.
At the time, you referred to the speech delivered by Pol Pot as well.
Phnom Penh?
Do you confirm that you never saw him in Phnom Penh?
Pardon, je vais préciser que c'est la page 91 en anglais.
Let me point out that it's page 91 in
et
English.
En Khmer 00924649.
one night.
I saw him on delivering
sur scène prononcer un discours.
Tam ka pet ka chuop
regarding the meeting and what I gave in my statement in 2007, if we consider, you know, moving back across time from 2007 to 1975, it was a long, long time between the two periods. So I did not have enough time to think about how to give the answer when I was interviewed. So I could not give a clear answer at that time about who was who when I was interviewed.
When you heard que Saint-Pan speak
over the radio, make a speech over the radio,
notamment 78,
in 1978 in particular, that is to say that after the Vietnamese had attacked Cambodia in 1977, so in 1978 did he speak about this war with Vietnam?
As far as I can remember, he made an announcement to soldiers to be on alert
aux soldats,
and be ready,
leur disant d'être sur un pied d'alerte,
to fight against the enemy who was
lutter contre l'ennemi
invading our territory.
Notre territoire.
So there was an announcement.
Donc il y a eu une déclaration, une annonce qui a été faite.
There was an announcement to make the public aware of this.
Et c'était pour que cela soit connu du public.
So it was a speech from him who was a senior leader of that regime.
Qui était un haut dirigeant du régime.
D'accord.
Fine.
Vous avez également parlé
you also spoke
qu'il avait
about
fait
a speech he made
avec le
during
Mayaguez,
the Mayaguez incident, during the capture of the Mayaguez vessel.
Est-ce que
and did Que Saint-Pan speak about
du fait que
the fact that the Americans had
dit
said that they got lost in the Cambodian territorial waters. What did Que Saint-Pan say about that?
I can recall at that time he did not say that the American ship got lost into our water, but
je me souviens pas qu'il a dit que le navire américain s'était perdu
from
dans
a media
show, mais c'était dans les médias
reported that the ship got lost into Cambodia territorial water.
S'était perdu dans les eaux territoriales cambodgiennes.
So Khieu Samphan at that time said that the American had a lot of modern technology. So how come that the American said that their vessel got lost into Cambodian water territory? President, thank you. It is now convenient time for the adjournment. The chamber will resume its hearing tomorrow at 9 a.m. to hear this witness, Prum Sarat. Please be informed. Thank you, Mr. Sarat.
Merci.
the hearing of your testimony has not come to an end yet. You are therefore invited to come and testify once again tomorrow at 9. And also, the Chamber would like to thank Mr. Muen Sawan, the Duty Counsel, and would like to invite you to come back tomorrow at 9 o'clock. Court officer with the Westu unit, please send Mr. Sarat to the place where he is staying at the moment and invite him back into the courtroom tomorrow at 9 a.m. Security personnel are instructed to bring Mr. Kiu Somphorn and Nuon Chia back to the detention facility and have them returned tomorrow morning before 9 a.m. The court is now adjourned.